Good morning, students. Yesterday we have seen the compression process of isothermal, polytropic and the isentropic. Now during these processes, when a process is isothermal, what is the change on the PV diagram and TS diagram? Also for the polytropic process and isentropic process, what are the changes in the PV and TS diagram? We have discussed. So from this we have concluded that the work done of isothermal process is less than the work done of the polytropic process, and work done of polytropic process is less than the work done of the isentropic process. Now we are going to calculate the work done by neglecting the clearance volume. That is the operations we are considering 4-2-1. It is the suction, when there is a suction at pressure is equal to constant. 1-2-2 is the compression process. That is the PV rest to N is equal to constant. It is the polytropic process we are considering. And 2-3 is the delivery process where pressure is again constant. Now the work done during the polytropic process, PV rest to N is equal to constant. So while calculating the work done during this process, the area under the curve means 4-1, 2-2, 2-3, 3-4. So this total area represents the work done during this cycle. So we are going to divide this area into known regions. So we are going to divide into two rectangular regions. And now just we are going to take the brief consideration of the work done calculation. If you see this figure, in this figure you can find that we are converting this figure into two rectangular portion and one polytropic process. Now we required the area of work done, that is the P1 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 P2 to again P1. So this area representing the work done during the polytropic process. But there is a suppose we are going to calculate the work done, first we have to calculate the area under this 2 to P2. This rectangular means O to A, A to 2, 2 to P2. So this rectangular area first we are going to calculate. Then secondly, that is the polytropic process, PV rest to N is equal to constant. So A to B, B to 1, 1 to 2 and 2 to A. This area we are going to calculate. Now we are going to subtract the region below the P1 to 1, because this is the region which is not under the consideration. So to calculate the actual work done, P1 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to P2, P2 to P1, we have to subtract the area from P1 to 1, 1 to B, B to O. So we are finding the work done, that is the O to A, A to 2, 2 to P2, P2 to again O, plus A to 2, 2 to 1, 1 to B, B to A. And we are going to subtract the area O to P1, P1 to 1, 1 to B, B to O. So in this way we are going to calculate the work done. So same formulation we are using for the different processes. Though there is a isentropic process, though there is a polytropic process, though there is a isothermal process, because the compression process is only different in this total work done calculation. So keep in the mind, so we have to just minus the area below this suction line, and as per the process we have to take the work done for the different processes. Now here we are taking the work done for the first region, it is the P2 V2. Now for second region, for the polytropic compression process, we know that the work done for any kind of the polytropic process, it is the P2 minus V2 into V2 minus P1 into V1 upon N minus 1. So this is the work done during the polytropic process. So we add both these and we have to subtract the region below the suction line, that is the minus P1 V1. So after a substitution, we got P2 V2 minus P1 V1 plus into bracket P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon N minus 1. So just we are going to rearrange the terms. So after rearranging the terms, we are going to take the common term, that is P2 V2 minus P1 V1 into bracket 1 plus 1 upon N minus 1. So we got the work done N upon N minus 1 P1 V1 into bracket P2 V2 upon P1 V1 minus 1. We are calling it as a equation number 1. So after the comparison between the isothermal work and the actual work is important. Isothermal efficiency, we know that the isothermal work done upon the actual work done. So for isothermal efficiency, actual work compression approaches to the isothermal compression. So we got actual work is equal to W actual. So while considering the PV diagram, we are getting the area 4 2 1 1 2 2 2 2 3 3 2 4. So during this process, we have to calculate the actual work done. So again, we are taking area 4 2 1 and minus area 1 to 2 minus area 2 to 3. So during this region, we are finding the work done P1 V1 minus of P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon N minus 1 minus of P2 V2. So again, we are going to rearranging the terms. So after rearranging, we are finding that the P1 V1 minus P2 V2 minus of into bracket P2 V2 minus P1 V1 upon N minus 1. So just we are going to reshuffle the terms to take the common terms P1 V1 minus P2 V2. So just we are taking the minus sign from the P2 V2 minus P1 V1 and it becomes positive. So we got P1 V1 minus P2 V2 plus P1 V1 minus P2 V2 upon N minus 1. So this is the actual work done we got. So again, we are going to rearranging, that is the W isothermal is equal to 1 plus 1 upon N minus 1 into bracket P1 V1 minus P2 V2. So N minus 1 we are going to multiply and we are making the base common. So it becomes N minus 1 plus 1 upon N minus 1. So here 1 get cancelled. So terms remaining is the N upon N minus 1. So into bracket P1 V1 minus P2 V2. Now we are going to take the common terms P1 V1 from the bracket. So we got N upon N minus 1 P1 V1 into bracket 1 minus P2 V2 upon P1 V1. Now we know that the during the polytropic process, P1 V1 raised to N is equal to P2 V2 raised to N equal to constant. So we are using this relation and we are going to substitute the value for the volume ratio, that is the V2 upon V1. So from this we got V2 upon V1 is equal to P1 upon P2 raised to 1 upon N. So we got the actual volume of the actual volume here, that is V2 upon V1. So we are going to substitute this value in the above isothermal work done. So we got the isothermal work done is equal to N upon N minus 1 P1 V1 into bracket 1 minus P2 upon P1 into bracket P1 upon P2 raised to 1 upon N bracket complete. So after rearranging, we got over here isothermal work done is equal to n upon n minus 1 p1 v1 and there 1 minus p2 upon p1 p1 upon p2 raised to 1 upon n. So now we are just making the p1 upon p2 is equal to p2 upon p1. So we know that 1 upon x is equal to x raised to minus s n minus 1. So in this way 1 upon x is equal to x raised to minus 1. So in this way we are changing, that is we are converting p1 upon p2 raised to 1 upon n is equal to p2 upon p1 raised to minus 1 upon n. So we are going to substitute this value in this work done equation. So we got n upon n minus 1 p1 v1 in bracket 1 minus p2 upon p1 into bracket p2 upon p1 raised to minus 1 upon n bracket complete. So here you are finding that the p2 upon p1 term constant here. So here becomes 1 minus of 1 upon n. So after solving this we got n minus 1 upon n. So we are going to substitute here values for the p2 upon p1 into bracket p2 upon p1 raised to 1 minus n, which is equal to p2 upon p1 raised to n minus 1 upon n. So work done for isothermal process, we can calculate n minus n upon n minus 1 p1 v1 into bracket 1 minus p2 upon p1 raised to n minus 1 upon n. So in this way we have calculated the work done for the polytropic process. So we can substitute for p1 v1 MRT1 also. So we got for isothermal process work done is equal to n upon n minus 1 MRT1 into bracket 1 minus p2 upon p1 raised to n minus 1 upon n. The solution, we were finding that the solution of this bracket is always negatives. So this shows that the work is done on the compressor. So also we know the relation T2 is equal to T1 into bracket P2 upon P1 raised to N minus 1 upon N. So in this way, after making the substitution, we are finding the work done also. So now, this is the work done for the isothermal process we have calculated. Now we are going to see the work done for the adiabatic process also. Now during this adiabatic process we are finding that PV raised to n is equal to constant during the adiabatic process, and we know that the for polytropic process PV raised to n is equal to constant. So after seeing this pressure volume diagram, you can clearly see that the work equation for polytropic process we have calculated PV raised to n is equal to constant, and for adiabatic process n is replaced with the gamma. So PV raised to gamma is equal to constant. Now process 4 to 1 volume V1 of air is aspirated into the compressor. Now at temperature T1 and the pressure P1. 1 to 2 process, air is compressed according to the PV raised to n is equal to constant from P1 to P2. So temperature increases from the T1 to T2. Now 2 to 3 process, compressed air at pressure P2 and volume V2 with temperature T2 is delivered. So work done during the isothermal process, PV is equal to constant, and for that area we have taken 4 to 1, 1 to 2 dash, 2 dash to 3, 3 to 4 represent the work done during the cycle. So as we know that P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. So work done we are finding during this process P1 V1 ln of V1 upon V2 dash. So after substitution also for P1 V1 we are substituting the MRT1, and for the V1 upon V2 dash we are substituting the P2 upon P1. So we got work done is equal to MRT1 ln of P2 upon P1. Now, since the temperature is constant, the pressure P in the work integral, that is W is equal to V1 to Vf, means whatever the F means changes up to the last, that is PdV. So this can be replaced, P is equal to nRT upon V using the ideal gas equation. So we got here the integral becomes work done, which is nRT, that is the VI to VF, or we are saying V1 to VF dV upon V. So this is we are representing on the pressure volume diagram, pressure volume chart also. So how the changes occurred on the PV plotting. Now during the compression, due to the excess temperature above the surrounding, the air will exchange the heat to the surrounding. Compression index N is always less than gamma, the adiabatic index here. Gamma is the adiabatic index, N is the polytropic index. So as compressor is work consuming device, every efforts is desired to reduce the work. So here you can find 1 to 2 double dash adiabatic compression maximum work, 1 to 2 polytropic compression, 1 to 2 dash isothermal compression, it is the minimum work. So work done, we are finding area under the PV curve over here. Now we are going to consider the work done by, in the case of the reciprocating compressor, with clearance volume. So see, with clearance volume the changes is here we are finding that the clearance volume is lies over here. So the in changes in the PV diagram, you can find the actual work done, you are finding 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and 4 to 1. So this shows you the actual work done. So the clearance volume, we know that the volume that remains inside the cylinder after piston reaches at the end, means in the top position, so the at the end of its inverse stroke. So above that means that top dead, we are saying it as a, so above that whatever the volume is present, that is called as the clearance volume. Now we have plotted the PV plotting. Here you can see the V1 is the total volume, and the effective stroke volume we are finding V1 minus V4, means this is the effective stroke volume, we are saying it as a, or effective swept volume we are saying it as a, that is the V1 minus V4. Okay, so this 4 to 1 represents the value of effective stroke volume. Now the actual work, is the way, as we have discussed, the area 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and again from 4 to 1. So this gives you the actual work. Now in this diagram, the clearance volume you are finding that the V3, that is the, we are calling it as a clearance volume. So V3 is equal to Vc, and swept volume we got over here, that is the swept volume V1 minus V3, it is the swept volume, and effective swept volume as we have discussed, V1 minus V4, and the compression and the expansion process is followed by the PV rest to N is equal to constant. So actual work done, whenever we are going to calculate, it is the area we are considering again 5 and 6 point. So P1 is the suction pressure at which the air is coming inside the compression chamber, and P2 is the higher pressure at which the air is delivered into the receiver. So we have to calculate the actual work done, area 5 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to to 6. So this area minus area 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 6. So we have to subtract this area. So this you give the actual work done. Now, compressor PV area without and with clearance volume, comparatively we can see over here. Here 3 and 4 point lies on the pressure line, but here 3 and 4 point lies in the PV area. So, this is the main difference in the PV diagram considering with clearance and without clearance over here. Now, reciprocating compressor equation, we are finding that the W actual is equal to the, as we are just placing the values of the work done for the polytropic process, we know that N upon N minus 1 P1 V1 into bracket 1 minus P2 upon P1 raised to N minus 1 upon N. So as we have previously find out this is the work done. So just we are taking the difference as we have discussed. So after placing we are subtracting N upon N minus 1 P4 V4 into bracket 1 minus P3 upon P4 raised to N minus 1 upon N. So see, so these are the actual area, that is 5 to 1, 1 to 2, 2 to 6. From this area, we are going to subtract the area of work from 5 to 4, 4 to 3, 3 to 6. So just we are placing the work done values in that equation and we got this total actual work done. But here we are finding that P4 is equal to P1 and P3 is equal to P2. So after substituting these values, we are getting that actual work done is equal to N upon N minus 1 P1 V1, because these terms become common because four terms is equal to first term. So definitely there is N upon N minus 1 P1 V1 is the common, and as the pressure P2 is equal to P3 and P1 is equal to P4, so the common factor becomes 1 minus P2 upon P1 raised to N minus 1. So we got the actual total work done is N upon N minus 1 P1 V1 into bracket 1 minus P2 upon P1 raised to N minus 1 upon N. So as we know that V1 is equal to V4, so we are going to substitute the also this equations we are going to substitute in the P4 V4 is equal to P1 V4. So after substitution we got N upon N minus 1 P1 common term we are taking outside, so remaining is V1 minus V4, and remaining is again we are taking into one bracket 1 minus P2 upon P1 into P1 upon P2 raised to 1 upon N. So again this situation becomes X into 1 upon X. So we are taking it as a X into X raised to minus 1. So in this way we are going to substitute the here values, and we got the actual work done there after substitution the values. So this gives you the actual work done for the that is with considering the clearance volume. Now the volumetric efficiency, the ratio of free air delivered to the displacement of the compressor, that is the ratio of effective swept volume to the swept volume in case of the presence of the clearance volume we are finding, and the volumetric efficiency is definitely less than 1. So we are finding it is between the 60 to 85%. So the volumetric efficiency, we know we are finding effective shaft volume upon the shaft volume. Effective shaft volume, it is the V1 minus V4, and the swept volume is V1 minus V3. So we are substituting these values and we are finding the volumetric efficiency. Now the clearance ratio. In the clearance ratio, clearance volume upon the swept volume. So clearance volume VC, that is V3, we know that, and swept volume we can find. So after substitution, the clearance volume and the swept volume, we are getting the clearance ratio. It is also called as the gamma, as also clearance ratio. So it is between the 4 to 10%. Now as the pressure ratio increases, this is the effect of the increase in the effect of the clearance volume. The clearance air expansion through the greater volume before the intake. Now the cylinder bore and the stroke are the fixed over there. So just we have to change the clearance volume. So effective swept volume, we know that V1 minus V4, as this decreases, with decrease in the effective swept volume, there is increase in the pressure volume. But the adverse effect is the, we are finding that the volumetric efficiency is the decreases. So this is the relation between the effective swept volume, pressure ratio, clearance volume, and the volumetric efficiency. So from this PV diagram, we are finding that the volumetric efficiency is equal to V1 minus V4 upon the V1 minus V3. So just adding and subtracting the volume V3, so we got V1 minus V3 plus into bracket V3 minus V4 upon V1 minus V3. Now we are getting the common term V1 minus V3 upon V1 minus V3, which is equal to 1 plus V3 upon V1 minus V3 minus of V4 upon V1 minus V4. So we got this. So 1 minus V3 upon V1 minus V3 minus of V4 upon V1 minus V3, we are going to multiply and divide by V3. So we got V3 upon V3 here. Now just we are going to rearrange the terms, that we are going taking the V3. So we got 1 plus V3 upon V1 minus V3 minus of V3 upon V1 minus V3, and we got V4 upon V1. So the common terms we are getting here, that is V3 upon V3 upon V1 minus V3. So in next we are taking this as a common. So volumetric efficiency becomes 1 plus V3 upon V1 minus V3 common we are taking, remaining terms 1 minus V3 upon V4. Because we know that V3 upon V4 is equal to here, and just we are taking the minus sign common over here. So after taking minus sign common, just here 1 minus V3 upon V1 minus V3, this is as it is. After taking the minus sign common, it becomes V3 upon V4 minus of 1. So we have seen that the V3 upon V4 is equal to P3 upon P4 raised to 1 upon N for the polytropic process, and we are going to replace this. So volumetric efficiency becomes 1 minus V3 upon V1 minus V3 into bracket P3 upon P4 raised to 1 upon N minus of 1. So volumetric efficiency for this we are taking as a C, introducing this C. So this C represent the clearance volume ratio, means the we are finding that the V3 is the clearance volume, it represents, and V1 minus V3 represent the swept volume. So this is the clearance ratio. So volumetric efficiency becomes 1 minus clearance volume ratio into bracket P3 upon P4 rest to 1 upon N minus of 1. So this gives you the volumetric efficiency with clearance volume. So this is related with the today's lecture. Thank you.